Hey there, everybody. Welcome to the Cactus Atlas. I'm Glenn, and today we're in a very cold and snowy Sedona, Arizona, about to experience Slide Rock State Park. Here's the first few footsteps into Slide Rock State Park, which many of you, I would not be surprised if you have been here or have heard of it. Typically a summer destination. I couldn't have picked a better day, in my opinion, to see this in the snow. I see snow almost never anymore. So for me, this is magical in this moment. And they got a good healthy amount, and you see it starting to melt. And certain hillsides don't have much left where others do. And you can see people have built snowmen here and there. I've seen people sledding out front. I mean, this is beauty. Beauty that I can't really convey unless you were here. My normal experience with this place is trying to drive on 89A, sometimes between Flagstaff and Sedona. I've stayed at cabins up here in Oak Creek, and in the summer times or the warmer months, noticing cars like spilling out onto the road like at 6 a.m. waiting to get parking spots in here. Yes, this place may be one of the most popular places in the state, and the main feature are natural rock slides. So we're not doing any swimming today, I assure you, but this should be quite a sight. So one of the things that I like about this location is, there's history, of course. You must know that about me so far. Not terribly much history, but the story goes back in the early 1900s, I want to say 1907-ish, a family moved out here and got this land through the Homestead Act. Basically, the federal government since the 1880s was trying to get people to come out and settle the area to boost the economy. So some lucky son of a gun got his hands on this, and I want to know how that happened. This would have just been a paradise on earth. And right here, you could see a sign that says tourist cabins built in 1933. And what I read about these are the owner of the land built these cabins to house an increasing tourist population once the word got out about the natural water slides that we're gonna seek out today. So some other historic buildings that I believe might still be around are maybe the actual original apple orchard even, or continuing orchards going into today, maybe a barn and some other relics of the time, farmhouse. We'll find out. Taking a casual approach to this today. These grounds are really pretty too. You're starting to see the evidence of orchards. Maybe those are the orchards, and I'm gonna tell you what, if those are the orchards, Amy, I'm not walking out there.
I just walked in the snow. I don't recommend.
Yeah, our feet are already wet. So I didn't bring my snow boots, because I don't even own snow boots. And this I don't remember, and I wonder if it's open seasonally. Although they're advertising hot chocolate, this is the Slide Rock Market. So I might be up for a delicious hot chocolate when we're done here. And they've got t-shirts. Oh, I need to extend my t-shirt collection, I think. It's closed though, darn it. How'd I know? Even though the scenery I don't think is the main draw of this place, it's certainly part of the draw. And boy, is that something. This is likely evidence of the homesteading history, the ranching history of this area. Different items, including a buzzsaw and various other horse-drawn implements, plows. It's interesting though, because I did not come out here with snowy conditions in mind, so Amy already learned her lesson the hard way. Maybe I need to join her and venture off into the snow. It's very soft and melty, you know, it's starting to turn into slush almost. But let's see if it's seems to make good snowmen from what I've seen. Oh yeah, very wet, packable snow. So great for snowball fights. And here you go, this is telling us the history. The gentleman's name that I was looking for is Frank Pendley, the first to visit this property in 1907. He saw the potential in it, of course, and set up some squatters' rights, and I think through the Homestead Act, was able to secure this all for himself. And these are all things that I presume are from that time, and I just had a big duh moment. Like right here behind us, I think, is part of that orchard. I mean, all the trees are without leaves now. I think these are apple trees, but they're all right here in front of us. And no, I'm not gonna go walk out amongst them. Sorry. It's kind of interesting too, because maybe for those few of you that don't really know about this park and the main draw, you're gonna be pretty amazed. You might already be amazed just by the red rocks of Sedona. That's enough to do it for people like me. But when you see the slides and chutes, then you'll understand what this place is truly all about. Here's a map of the Slide Rock Apple Orchards. I don't know if this is representative of the time when this was in its heyday or if it's representative of today, but you can see here, if we're here, then to the right of me is this is an orchard. It looks like it is possibly apple trees with the little red dots in there, but they have apricots. Probably, there you go, Rome Beauty, Golden Delicious. So a variety of apples, English walnut. They, just like the original homesteaders did, they grow vegetables, it looks like, here too on this property. So absolutely beautiful. I believe I've read that when apples are in season here, I think they're free for the picking. As you'll find in other places, like Lee's Ferry has a similar concept up in northern Arizona, where there's an orchard up there where you can pick more than just apples whenever things are in season. And I think this is the same idea. Although I bet you when the crowds start coming in, when the weather's a little bit warmer, when apples would be in season, they probably don't last long, would be my guess. But imagine being one of the earliest settlers of this area and stumbling upon this and calling this your land, your own. It is a very fertile area with abundant wildlife, lots of running water. I assume the soil was good. So, sceneries to boot, I mean, come on, this is where it's at. And here's the Pendley Homestead House, built in 1927. So this one is very close to 100 years old and has probably survived many snowstorms in this region. So if I have the story right, I think this family, after they got this land, ended up building this homestead, this ranch farm, and owned this land until the 1980s. This was one of the largest private land parcels in this general area in Sedona. I already forget my Wikipedia-ing from earlier, but something along the lines of, for whatever circumstances had it, the family was ready to sell the land or give it to the public, and then the state of Arizona became interested in this and acquiring it. Well, clearly it's a state park today, but sounds like there was opposition to the idea at the time. All right, so I think that's all the historic stuff, or the bulk of it, and now we're gonna get to the meat of it, the thing that everybody comes here for, right down this way, as I think, down this trail.
Thank you.
further deeper in we go in here, there's like nobody here. Maybe it means it's too slippery or something, but the slide rock swim area. Dun 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 dun. Yeah, and in the summertime, there's just, I'm gonna guess, hundreds of people, as many as they can cram in here without exceeding the limit, and it's constant. So there's just no way for me, that's not for me, that's not a good time. Maybe if you have kids and people want to run and play and have fun, that'd be a little bit better. I like peace and quiet, and that is not peace and quiet. These trails down here are very slippery and icy, and it's kind of like intermittent. But right down below, you see like the start of the main draw. Now we're gonna walk upstream, up the trail, and it's gonna get really pretty. But I don't know how far we can actually go down that ways. These shoes I have are not good for traction, and if I can get onto the rock's fine. The rock's got grip. It's the snowy slush on top that's the problem. But it is muddy. It is muddy. But you tell me, is it worth it for coming up here to see this? Nobody else is coming over here. This should be Oak Creek, running right here through the heart of Oak Creek Canyon, parallel to Route 89A. Areas we've explored before. You can see this creek is flowing really well with all the snow. I'm sure it's the snowmelt, the recent rains, all of it, turning this into a beautiful mountain stream. You can see the trail kind of continues. Here's not too bad. And there's a lot of up and down. So even if this was dry, for some people this could be a challenge, I would reckon. But I love how the water is just glistening and dripping off of everything here. And if this were summertime, you would see scores of people swimming down in this area here. And I think we're approaching the natural water slides where you can truly slide down slick rocks. And the trails here are quite short, so I want to say this thing's like a third of a mile long. We may be getting to kind of the end, so I reckon this might be the water slide area proper, where you see a lot of people doing that. Now, we'll keep going as far as we can, but with the restrooms being like right there, kind of makes me think this is like a main hangout area for folks. And there's Route 89, where we started this trail. Right over there. I honestly forgot how beautiful Slide Rock State Park is. I mean, it is one of what I would recommend, one of the premier destinations here in Sedona, as long as you can avoid the crowds. If you like a nice stroll and don't want to get wet, you could see this is a good time of year to come here. And with the snow to boot, this is magic. It's like something from a movie almost. Place I could just hang out at it though for a very long time, but the scene says it all itself. Now this spot cleared up, so I'm gonna kind of hang out with in a place that I bet is the prime spot. It'd be like the place everybody rushes to when they want to set up their towels. I bet it's right down there. You get some sun, some chill, And that's some loud water. Some rapids right there. And I think you can literally slide like down this thing here. I've seen people do it.
All right, so now you got to see what gives Slide Rock State Park its name. This rock that I couldn't demonstrate to you today how to slide down it, as nobody else would either, because I assure you, I just dunked my foot full on in some of the water, and woo, doggy, is it cold. No thank you. All right, so I made it back up to the top. Looking at my progress, this is where that other trail starts, by the way. So I don't know how many good of views you'd get, but the main attraction is down there. Well, folks, this view going back to towards the parking lot might be the one of the day, and it's a proper place to part ways with you. I don't even know what else I gotta show you. I think the video speaks for itself. Take it or leave it, Slide Rock State Park. I happen to love it.